describes the peace that we have with God through grace is a peace that surpasses all understanding. And I'm learning through this time that you can have that sense of peace and be connected to it even while there is a sense of discomfort or change. You can even have peace while suffering, while bearing the pain of your own suffering or the suffering of others. And it would seem counterintuitive or paradoxical for peace and suffering to be held together, but that's the very kind of thing that God's peace brings to us and helps us to get through some of these things that are big changes for a lot of people and have a lot of people uneasy. I guess I used to think that peace meant more comfort and ease, but now I'm seeing that there's an overriding peace that comes even when we embrace the things that are not so comfortable and the changes that come.
I think the thing that probably God has done the most is just really brought home how much I'm not in control. I think as, you know, again, I've been here 20 years and I think God, you know, when you're young, you're prideful and ambitious. You try not to be, but you are. And as I get older, I'm more and more realized, boy, I don't have as control over the dynamics of the church or even of my own life like I wish I did. And this whole quarantine has just crashed that all completely down, but in a good way to say, God, I kind of chuckle sometimes and say, God, I never had control anyways. And now you're just reminding me how much I really don't have control. I have to trust you and trust you that you're going to, and I've been telling my congregation since day one, this has been my mantra. God is in control. God can work all things together for the good, and God will see us through. And I really do believe that.
Thank you for listening to our video. Please click on another to learn more. And don't forget to ring the bell to like us.